Coming up, protests erupt over a grand jury's decision not to bring charges against Louisville police officers for the death of Breonna Taylor.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News at 11.
Good evening, I'm Steve Hensley. A grand jury decided one of the police officers involved in the shooting of Breonna Taylor will face criminal charges, but not for her death. After the announcement, protests broke out in Louisville and cities across the country. At least two police officers were shot tonight in Louisville. The injuries are believed to be non-life-threatening. CBS's Elise Preston begins our top story team coverage from Louisville.
Protesters gathered across the nation, including in Atlanta, Washington, D.C., New York, and Louisville, after a Kentucky grand jury charged one officer, but not for the shooting death of Breonna Taylor.
They're basically saying it's illegal to kill, murder black people in the streets or in their sleep. It's sad to say, but we used to them getting away with murder.
Late Wednesday, the Louisville Police Department said two officers were shot. Earlier, several protesters were arrested amid clashes.
The safety of our officers and the community we serve is of utmost importance.
A grand jury charged fired officer Brett Hankison with three counts of wanton endangerment for firing into the homes of Taylor's neighbors during a March 13th narcotics investigation. No drugs were ever found in Taylor's home.
The decision before my office as the special prosecutor in this case was not to decide if the loss of Ms. Taylor's life was a tragedy. The answer to that question is unequivocally yes.
The panel brought no charges against any of the three officers in connection with the 26-year-old emergency room technician's death. Taylor was shot six times in the hallway of her apartment.
She's in the sanctity of her home, the place where you are expected to be safe.
Taylor's boyfriend, who has said he mistook the officers for intruders, opened fire first, hitting an officer in the leg. If convicted, Hankison faces up to 15 years behind bars. Elise Preston, CBS News.
Now, police say both officers that were shot tonight are stable and one was undergoing surgery. They say a suspect is in custody. Governor Beshear just released a video statement on Facebook reacting to the officer-involved shootings, urging protesters to go home, saying the answer to violence is never more violence. The governor made a public request of Attorney General Daniel Cameron to release any possible evidence in the Breonna Taylor case now that the investigation into her death is concluded. Though Governor Beshear did not openly argue or disagree with the investigation's findings, he stressed the importance of the public being able to process the information for themselves.
And now I'm making a request that he post online all the information, evidence, and facts that he can release without impacting the three felony counts in the indictment issued today. Everyone can and should be informed. And those that are currently feeling frustration, feeling hurt, they deserve to know more.
Now, Attorney General Cameron said he does not plan on making information public because it could impact the investigation into the charges against Hankison. Presidential candidates also weighed in on the grand jury indictment. President Trump commended Attorney General Cameron on his investigation, while Democratic candidate Joe Biden addressed the protesters, calling for them to be peaceful.
What I did hear on the way here on the radio, that there may be people protesting. One thing I want to make clear, protesting makes a lot of sense. It's clear people should be able to speak, but no violence. No violence. My heart goes out to Breonna Taylor's mom. The last thing she needs is to see violence in the street. So protest peacefully, no violence.
Well, I thought it was really brilliant. Kentucky Attorney General Daniel Cameron is doing a fantastic job. I think he's a star.
President Trump said he was also talking with Governor Beshear tonight by phone. He said calling in the National Guard was a positive decision. The ACLU called the grand jury indictment, quote, the latest miscarriage of justice in our nation's long history of denying that black lives matter, unquote. The statement goes on to say, quote, this outcome shows us that true police accountability does not exist in Kentucky. Again, that from the ACLU. While the Attorney General's investigation is complete, the FBI is doing its own independent investigation into the Breonna Taylor shooting. That investigation is looking into any potential civil rights violations. Federal investigators were at Taylor's apartment back in June to re-examine physical and video evidence. They also talked to witnesses from that night. The FBI ballistics report was also a key piece of Attorney General Cameron's investigation. Since Taylor's death, no-knock warrants are now banned in the city of Louisville. City Council unanimously banned Breonna's unanimously passed Breonna's law in June. It not only bans no-knock warrants, it also requires officers wait a minimum 15 seconds after knocking and announcing their presence when serving a warrant. Officers must wear body cameras while executing a warrant, turning them on 5 minutes before and off at least 5 minutes after the warrant is served. Louisville Mayor Greg Fisher has now issued three executive orders this week. First was a declaration of a state of emergency. The second, closing parking garages and on-street parking in Louisville. Then this afternoon, a new curfew announcement.
My third executive order sets a countywide 72-hour curfew from 9 p.m. to 6:30 a.m. beginning tonight. The curfew does not apply to people in the community to work, going to and from work, houses of worship for services, or those seeking medical attention for themselves or others. Most of the violence that we've encountered over the past few months has occurred after dark. So we are asking that if you decide to join a protest, you wrap things up by 8 o'clock or so, and so you can start to head home and be home by 9 p.m.
And obviously a lot of protesters not abiding by that curfew tonight. LMPD Interim Chief Robert Schroeder reiterating today police will not tolerate violence or destruction of property. Under Mayor Fisher's order, all Metro government buildings, including City Hall and Metro Hall, will be closed all day Thursday. The mayor issuing a plea for downtown businesses to allow employees to work from home if possible. The grand jury decision grabbed a lot of attention in the mountains, too. WYMT's Tommy Poole sat down with some of the members of UPike's Black Student Union to gather their thoughts.
Plenty of eyes were on Daniel Cameron's office in the state of Kentucky Wednesday.
I don't feel like we've got anything. I don't feel like nothing has been accomplished.
The group, like many, looked to the grand jury to prosecute all three officers involved in the shooting of Breonna Taylor.
I had a feeling it was going to turn out this way when I saw them preparing, you know, downtown Louisville for what looked like a hurricane. Not really shocked, but I am heartbroken right now. Because justice was not served.
One group that was watching closely, members of UPike's Black Student Union.
I just feel like their neighbors got more justice than she did.
While the students feel justice was not served, they say the conversation for police reform must continue.
The police department does, and everywhere needs to have funding that is cut, and it can go to the housing authorities. It can go to social work, you know, social workers and things like that. So it's not anti-police. We want to help make the police better for us.
As the state and nation begins to move forward. Tommy Poole, WYMT, Mountain News.
Students at the University of Kentucky were also keeping up with the Breonna Taylor case. They watched the indictment come down, as well as the explanation from Attorney General Daniel Cameron. UK law professor Blanche Bong Cook is still looking ahead to the next steps of the trial process. And as for her opinion on the indictment itself, her jury is still out.
I'd like a lot more evidence in this case, but I also understand that there's some real parameters here to releasing the evidence to the public. I understand that the prosecutors involved in the case have ethical obligations that require them to maintain some secrecy.
UK President Eli Capiluto sent a message out to the entire campus community saying the MLK Center and counseling centers would be open for students who need to reflect or ask questions. Tensions have remained high throughout the night in Louisville as protests have grown in size. The National Guard says 500 Guard members were deployed to Louisville to help with the protests. Caitlin Russ shows us the scene a short time ago from downtown.
We're here at the intersection of 6th and Chestnut. It seems that police are starting to disperse crowds because small fires are being kind of lit all over the area. Right here at this River City Bank, if you look down there where those fire department are, that's where a small fire was set. It was just smoldering. It wasn't actually burning. But if you take a look down this way, once this fire truck moves, we've got an entire line of LMPD moving down the street. I don't know why they're coming in this direction because there's very few protesters down here. But we're going to continue to monitor this situation as it develops. We're trying to head back towards Jefferson Square Park, where the focus is tonight, where all the protesters are tonight. There have been some small splinter groups that we've been following. That's why we're out this far. But right now we're going to make it back to the park in Louisville. Caitlin Rust.
All right, Caitlin, thank you very much. From our sister station, WAVE have been doing an excellent job covering the protests tonight. There have also been peaceful protests in Lexington tonight. We'll, of course, keep you updated on all this as the night goes on our website, WYMT.com, where you can find more of today's coverage on the grand jury decision.
We've seen those cloudy skies throughout the day here in the mountains. More clouds are possible tomorrow, along with more of those rain chances. We'll take you up to that camera up towards Moorhead. Interstate 64 dry, but still seeing those gloomy skies heading into the overnight hours. Dry along Interstate 75 into Mount Vernon, and most of us going to remain on that dry side tonight. It's not until tomorrow we start to see those rain chances. So for tonight, we'll drop it to the upper 50s to lower 60s. Few showers are possible, but overall, we're really not going to see most of that rain arrive until tomorrow, which is when the rain chances increase. However, we will see some sunshine as we head into the weekend and tracking another nice cool down heading into next week. I'll have a look at that 7-day forecast coming up.
All right, Paige, thank you. Eastern Kentucky continues to see an increase in COVID-19 cases, especially in certain counties. The governor announced 796 new cases of COVID-19 today. The statewide total increased to 63,517. There were 5 new deaths today, bringing the death toll to 1,124. The positivity rate increased to 4.59%. At least 11,480 Kentuckians have recovered from the virus. For more specific reports from health departments across the region, go to our website at WYMT.com. We have an update tonight from the University of Pikeville. The university announced that based on the recommendation from the Pike County Health Department, they will extend its Level 4 guidance and continue virtual learning. Students will not go back to in-person learning or partake in athletic activities until Monday, October 12th, after an increase in cases on campus. Members of the White House Coronavirus Task Force testified on Capitol Hill today, and the discussions got heated at times. Dr. Anthony Fauci and Kentucky Senator Rand Paul had a few choice words for one another. Paul questioned Fauci's praise for New York's handling of the virus, while Fauci claimed Senator Paul was not listening to health experts.
You've been a big fan of Cuomo and the shutdown in New York. You've lauded New York for their policy. New York had the highest death rate in the world. How could we possibly be jumping up and down and saying, oh, Governor Cuomo did a great job? He had the worst death rate in the world.
No, you misconstrued that, Senator, and you've done that repetitively in the past. They got hit very badly. They've made some mistakes. Right now, if you look at what's going on right now, the things that are going on in New York to get their test positivity 1% or less is because they are looking at the guidelines that we have put together from the task force of the 4 or 5 things of masks, social distancing, outdoors more than indoors, avoiding crowds, and washing hands.
Or they've developed enough community immunity that they're no longer having the pandemic because they have enough immunity in New York City to actually stop.
I challenge that, Senator. I would like to be able to do this because this happens with Senator Rand all the time. You were not listening to what the director of the CDC said, that in New York, it's about 22%. If you believe 22% is herd immunity, I believe you're alone in that.
Currently, 20 states plus Washington, D.C. and Puerto Rico are reporting increases in new coronavirus cases from 2 weeks ago. Many local officials are releasing their plans for Halloween in their communities. The Knott County Judge Executive released a video today with details of what trick-or-treating will look like there, including requiring people handing out candy to wear masks. Jeff Dobson also says they will have trick-or-treat earlier from 4 until 6 p.m. while it's still daylight. He hopes this will help people stay socially distanced.
A lot of times when it's dark, you go up to trick-or-treat, a lot of kids, they dart in the house, or there may be some of the individuals that's giving the candy out. They want to see the kids, want to see what kind of costumes. They want them to come in the house in the light.
Knott County will have its Halloween on Saturday, October 31st. Dobson encourages people to just carpool with their family and to limit one family at a time per house. The governor said today he hoped to have some guidance on Halloween activities soon. We'll be right back.
I was lied to and cheated. Now, that's exactly how I feel. Last year, we visited Senator Mitch McConnell to help miners with black lung.
But we ended up in Amy McGrath's ad attacking Mitch.
We thought we was trying to help the people to hear our story about black lung. But that wasn't what it was. It was a campaign commercial. I think Amy McGrath's responsible for it, and I'm not going to be part of it. And I made him take my picture off of it.
I don't think I was treated fair. I believe I was lied to.
McGrath's ad is a lie, and that's why she had to take us out of it. Amy McGrath's telling the meeting with Mitch McConnell was not truthful.
Truth is, Mitch visited with us, and he told us miners he'd take care of us, and he did.
Mitch helped miners with black lung and helped protect our pensions, too.
That's the truth, and nothing Amy McGrath can say can change that. Amy McGrath flat out lied about Mitch.
And Kentucky deserves better.
I'm Mitch McConnell, and I approve this message.
Attention CPAP users. Have you been looking for a small CPAP but haven't found the answer? Bye-bye, big and bulky. Now you can have the freedom to sleep everywhere with Transcend Mini CPAP. Enjoy all the features you expect from a home device in a CPAP that's half the size. Try it for yourself and sleep in comfort every night, everywhere. Call or go online now to try the Transcend Mini CPAP risk-free for 10 nights. Call 1-800-253-0949, 1-800-253-0949, or visit mytranscend.com.
Hello, Bob Patcherson here for Hutch Jeep, and we're having our back-to-school sales event. Buy any pre-owned vehicle, and you'll receive a $250 gift card, or when you buy a new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, or Ram, you can get a $500 gift card for back-to-school shopping. Right now, save up to $14,000 on new Ram trucks, and there's several to choose from. And remember, the Hutch Guarantee.
Don't settle for outdated security technology. Getting smart home security has never been easier. Microtech and Alula have teamed up to bring you the best home security offering in Eastern Kentucky. Now you can bundle your home security and broadband. It's never been easier. Plus, we offer all the bells and whistles you've come to expect from Microtech. Call now at 1-800-264-1730 and sign up today. With Microtech and Alula, families matter.
Sky Alert Weather, sponsored by Community Trust Bank. Building communities built on trust.
Eastern Kentucky native Josh Martin is on his way back home. The Nashville musician is bringing his sound to the hills of Prestonsburg Friday night for a concert under the stars at the Jenny Wiley Amphitheater. While social distancing guidelines are in place, Martin says he is excited to be performing a stripped-down show for his hometown neighbors.
I'm looking even more forward to playing at the Jenny Wiley Amphitheater because I remember way back in the day when the Kentucky Opry was down there, and I've got so many good childhood memories of that place. Kind of a front porch concert is really what I'm envisioning.
Tickets are still available for $20 each. You can find a link for those on our website at WYMT.com.
We've seen those clouds increasing throughout the day. A few showers have even moved in, but most of the showers don't look to arrive until tomorrow. Satellite and radar showing those showers mainly down into the Cumberland Valley. Not all of those reached the ground areas along I-75 and west of that saw most of the showers today. Taking a look at the bigger picture, though, it's all because of the remnants of once Tropical Storm Beta. It'll continue to kind of trek into our region, which will provide some more rain heading into tomorrow and definitely providing some heavy rain even down into parts of East Tennessee, and hopefully that's where it is going to stay. As you can see here in Future View, we're going to start to see those lighter showers right around 7 o'clock in the morning. Temperatures upper 50s to lower 60s. Heading throughout the day, scattered rain chances possible. Some of us might not even get into the 70s tomorrow. Definitely something to keep an eye on with that cloud cover. If you're kind of north of the Hal Rogers Parkway or north of Highway 80, you might mostly remain on that dry side for tomorrow. Some scattered showers possible. You see that heavy rain mainly staying down into East Tennessee, parts of Virginia. So if you're along that Kentucky, Virginia, and Tennessee border, you guys could definitely see pockets of heavy rain, depending on if this moves a little bit more to the north. And then hopefully by the time we get a little bit later Friday, just dealing with some stray rain chances, and those start to move out heading throughout the day. They're showing around right around noon, still dealing with some stray rain chances, but most of us starting to dry out. So how much rain are we expecting? Now, Future View suggesting that most of the rain stays more to the south of us. So you could see only about half an inch, possibly to an inch of rain, while some other models had that band of heavy rain coming a little bit closer into the mountains. So it could provide about an inch or two down into parts of the Cumberland Valley. So this is something we'll keep an eye on. We're going to have to watch where that low pressure treks and if we're going to see that heavy rain move all the way into eastern Kentucky or stay down into parts of East Tennessee. Either way, we are going to start to dry out by Friday evening and into the later evening hours. By heading into the weekend, though, we are going to see plenty of sunshine, upper 70s to lower 80s before we're tracking another cold front and another cool down by next week. Don't go anywhere. We'll have more WYMT Mountain News coming up right after the break.
When you see news happening, dial star 57 or text your news tips to 5757. Services provided by Appalachian Wireless. Better service, bigger savings.
Your daughter got her learner's permit, so you're getting her favorites at McDonald's. Enjoying the journey together? That's something to value. Right now, mix and match two select breakfast favorites for just $2.
Legendary.
During the Today's the Day event, lease a new 2020 Tacoma SR Double Cab for $179 a month or get big customer cash on Tacoma, 4Runner, and Tundra up to $2,250. Toyota, let's go places.
When you're injured, you can count on me. There's only one Morgan & Morgan for the people.
My family of Blackburns, Maynards, Reeds, Hamiltons, Newsoms, Halls, Tacketts, Kaisers, Laffertys, and DeRossets are all Eastern Kentucky born and bred. They are and have been teachers, miners, and truck drivers. They've laid gas lines and blacktop, the makeup of our infrastructure. They taught me the value of education, hard work, and respect. I'm running because I love my home here in Eastern Kentucky, and I want to see us prosper. I'm running to represent the 31st District. I'm running because we deserve better.
This is Gary C. Johnson. Tune us in Tuesday night, 7 o'clock, sip it along. Have some fun with me and Keith. It's not a very negative show.
Your daughter got her learner's permit, so you're getting her favorites at McDonald's. Enjoying the journey together? That's something to value. Right now, mix and match two select breakfast favorites for just $2.
The WYMT News app offers alerts on breaking stories as they happen, customized to the categories you choose. The WYMT News app, powered by Appalachian Wireless.
Today marked the first of 3 days of public ceremonies for the late Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, who died last week at the age of 87 from pancreatic cancer. The vacancy left on the court has ignited a political battle less than 6 weeks from Election Day. CBS's Deborah Alfarone has more from the U.S. Supreme Court.
Mourners came to the U.S. Supreme Court to pay their respects to the late Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, among them former President Bill Clinton and Hillary Clinton, and Vice President Mike Pence.
She meant so much to so many of us.
She really led an impactful life.
At a private memorial service in the Great Hall of the Supreme Court Wednesday morning, the history-making legal icon was honored for her work pursuing equal rights for all Americans.
This was Justice Ginsburg's life's work, to insist that the Constitution deliver on its promise, that we, the people, would include all the people.
Her 483 majority, concurring, and dissenting opinions will steer the court for decades.
As the nation continues to honor the legacy of the late Justice Ginsburg, President Trump is preparing to name her successor.
The person I'll be putting up is highly qualified, totally brilliant. You'll see on Saturday who that is. I can't imagine why a Democrat wouldn't vote for this person.
President Trump appears to have the support from enough Senate Republicans to get a vote on his nominee, despite opposition from the Democrats. Sources tell CBS News, federal appeals court judge Amy Coney Barrett is a leading contender after the president met with her twice this week at the White House.
Women's rights as it relates to everything from medical health care. It's gonna be gone.
2020 Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden called the rush to push through a nominee an abuse of power, and he called on voters to make their voices heard. Deborah Alferone, CBS News, the Supreme Court.
President Trump says he will travel to the Supreme Court tomorrow morning to pay his respects to the late Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Coming up in sports, one Kentucky coach gets emotional talking about Chris Oates as the junior linebacker continues the battle in rehab.
Kemper Furniture in Hazard has over 120 Lazy Boy recliners in stock, starting at only $299. Get custom England furniture made just for you in 18 days or less. Kemper's has the area's largest selection of bedroom groups, dining room groups, and mattresses. With quick in-home delivery and up to 24 months interest-free, Kemper's makes it easy and affordable. Kemper's in Hazard, where we know furniture.
You can be healthy. You can eat right. You can even have good genes. But with cancer, there may be other risk factors you should know. So take an online assessment from Baptist Health, which can tell you your risk, lead to early detection, or simply peace of mind. It's world-class care even before you need it.
While Washington talks about Mitch McConnell jamming through a Supreme Court nomination, he wouldn't jam through more help for laid-off Kentucky workers. It's always the same. For too many in Kentucky, little has changed after 36 years of Mitch McConnell. But his donors are better off. He's better off. His staffers who became lobbyists are better off. But are you better off? We can vote him out.
I'm Amy McGrath, and I approve this message.
If something happened to you, what would happen to them? Their home, their education, their future. You need life insurance. And chances are, SelectQuote can help you get it for less than a dollar a day.
SelectQuote found Jacob 40, a $500,000 policy for only $19 a month. And SelectQuote found his wife Wendy, a $500,000 policy for only $17 a month.
Our secret? At SelectQuote, we aggressively comparison shop highly rated companies to find you the company with the best rates.
We found Gary, 35, a $1 million policy for only $22 a month.
Why pay more? Give your family the security they need at a price you can afford.
Call 1-800-592-1010 or go to SelectQuote.com now and get the insurance your family needs.
At a price you can afford. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
This is WYMT Mountain Sports, your home for the Kentucky Wildcats and local high school sports.
As head coach Mark Stoops mentioned on Monday, the Kentucky Wildcats plan to honor Chris Oates throughout the season as Oates continues to recover. Oates is currently in a rehabilitation center in Cincinnati, recovering from a non-COVID-19 related medical issue. Oates' value to Kentucky was clear in hearing defensive coordinator Brad White's words about the junior linebacker.
To be able to have that 22 out on the field will be something special, and it's going to be emotional, you know, and you're going to see it out there. But it was, I, I'm really excited to be able to see that. You know, I know each player that gets to wear it is going to take great pride in wearing that.
So DeAndre Square will wear the 22 to start the season. Then Keaton Upshaw, Oates' roommate, will wear it in the home opener against Ole Miss on October 3rd. For now, the Cats are focused on their opener against number 8 Auburn. Game kicks off on Saturday at noon on the SEC Network. Another week of high school football season in the books means yet another WYMT Player of the Week. And coming into the 2020 season, the Pikeville Panthers had a lot to live up to. A perfect 14-0 season and a Class 1A state championship. WYMT's Camille Gear talks to one Panther who's stepping up to the plate. It's Blake Birchfield inside the five. You're going to hear that name a lot tonight.
The Pikeville Panthers lost 16 key pieces to graduation last season, looking for some younger guys to be the next man up.
He's worked extremely hard in the offseason. Even when we couldn't get together, I know that his dad had him working out and running and those kind of things. So he's been preparing for this moment, and he stepped up big for us his first two games.
And it looks like they found just that in Blake Birchfield. Now a sophomore, Birchfield got varsity playing time in the state championship game, giving him confidence for the upcoming season.
I think that kind of motivated him in the offseason to do what he did because he wanted to come out and be the best player he could and help our team win. So he did all that, and he's reaping the rewards now.
Just 2 weeks into the season, he has 270 rushing yards and 3 touchdowns. Against Belfry, Birchfield had 14 of Pikeville's 20 points.
To be honest, I didn't expect to get that many carries, and I was expected to line up and get a few throws to me and stuff, but, you know, I'm happy it is the way it is. And
giving the glory to his teammates and his brothers.
Oh, it's such a blessing. It really is. I've let Isaac, the line, know that, you know, they're the reason for my success. It's really like a brotherhood. You know, they really feel like I'm the little brother to block for me, you know.
And looking forward to the games ahead. In Pikeville, Camille Gear, WYMT, Mountain Sports.
Rams defenders to the end zone. Pikeville strikes first, 6-0.
Birchfield said he hopes this momentum carries on for the Panthers throughout the season. They take on 6A Henry Clay this coming Friday. And that is sports. We'll be right back.
I own and run a construction company in Bowling Green. My employees are like family to me, and I'm proud to provide them with good health insurance. But Amy McGrath wants to pass a government takeover of health care that could ban private and union-provided coverage. McGrath's socialist plan would cost $32 trillion, and it would double our income taxes. Amy McGrath is too liberal for Kentucky.
Keep Kentucky Great is responsible for the content of this advertising.
This is Bruce Walters at Bruce Walters Kia. Right now, the Kia Summer Sticker Sales event's going on. And what's that mean to you? Don't pay any attention to the sticker. New 2020 Kia Sorento. Sticker price, $29,819. Bruce Walters Kia price, just $21,590. Save over $8,000. Remember, don't pay any attention to the sticker. Come shop us in Pikeville or shop us online at brucewalterskia.com.
As the lazy days of summer give way to the cool, crisp breezes of autumn, the time comes for a vibrant array of colors, cozy jackets, and great saving at Food City.
This week's save on Food City Fresh Ground Chuck, $2.99 a pound, 3 pounds or more. Jumbo Pack Holly Farms Boneless Chicken Breast, $1.99 a pound. Lay's Potato Chips, buy more, save more, $1.99 each when you buy two, and more.
Love you everything, Food City.
Cancer. We know it's a scary diagnosis.
But you are not alone. We are here with you.
We are here for you.
Together, we will fight this.
We're coming after you, cancer.
With technology,
compassion,
and faith.
And faith.
Because together,
we fight cancer.
Let's talk
talk about the Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross. At Walters Mitsubishi, you will find this uniquely styled mid-sized SUV. It's all-wheel drive and comes with a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. The Eclipse is sharp, and it starts at $22,650. Plus, qualified buyers can get 0% financing with a $1,000 rebate. Oh, and here is the big news. There is 15 to choose from.
Remember, when others won't, Walters will.
Closed captioning presented by Wolf Williams and Reynolds, serving Eastern Kentucky for Social Security and Federal Black Lung.
It's been a long day. Thanks for joining us. Have a good night, everyone.